demonstrated his passion for the work, and I liked the way that he did it. I felt no like trusted him at Hello, even despite the fact that he didn't have any certifications beside his name or any fancy credentials. Here's a guy that just loves to move furniture around and make the space look great, and if I'm looking for a home stager, maybe this guy's my man. So what's another big mistake? The number two biggest mistake. This is what I call going generic in a sea of sameness. Did anyone here go to college? Like I did. Remember the first 2 years of college, you were kind of seeing, you know, bending and swaying and not quite declaring what you were going to do or be. But when you declared your major, all of a sudden you got serious and maybe you made Dean's List and maybe you got all kinds of scholarships and maybe all of a sudden you set yourself apart and got yourself situated so you could get that awesome big high-paying job. Well, I think that with our bios, we need to declare our intention to be major in our field. And that means that you don't have to wait for the crown. You get to crown yourself. If Maple Valley is your territory and you're an award-winning real estate agent doing business in Maple Valley, then say you're an award-winning Maple Valley real estate specialist. Claim your geography if that's what you want. Claim something that can be yours. I was talking to my husband the other day and I said, we were talking about Michael Phelps and the whole idea of how hard it is to choose a lane. Mm-hmm. And I just said, choose a lane and get in the pool. Choose a lane, get in the pool and reach for the wall. That's how you win. You don't win by being tippy-toe in the water. That's not how you win. You gotta jump on in. Frank Perdue found a way to differentiate dead poultry. Mm-hmm. He said, it takes a tough bird to make a tender chicken. If you're in the grocer's aisle and you're trying to decide what kind of chicken you're going to buy, maybe this guy is going to help you reach for the Purdue Farms. So how are you going to set yourself apart? Here's some ways. Do you specialize in a particular neighborhood? Do you only deal in luxury properties, island properties? Do you have a signature system? How many years of experience do you have? How many deals have you done over how many years? How many awards have you won? What's your distinct point of view? And do you look awesome in photography? Do you look today like your picture does on Facebook? Never forget the time that I was meeting a guy that I never met before, and he says, I'll meet you at the Starbucks in Factoria. I'm tall, 6'4". And I said, me too, I'm tall. I said, how will I know it's you? And he said, oh, you know, I'm tall, 6'4", you can't miss me. So I went to his website and I saw this picture of this guy with very dark brown hair. So I show up at the Starbucks and I'm looking around for someone tall and there was nobody standing, so I couldn't assess how tall he was. And then I thought, stage two, I'll look for brown hair. And I'm looking for brown hair. So then this man approached me and he says, are you Nancy Judd? And I said, yes, and total gray hair, 100%. If you're gonna fib about what you look like, are you gonna do business in the same manner? Make sure the words in the pictures match, okay? Here's an award-winning Maple Valley real estate specialist, Elsie Shajwan. In the best and most challenging of times, clients seeking to buy their first home, invest in real estate, or move up to their dream homes say great things about award-winning real estate agent and lasting relationship builder, Elsie. And then she's got a couple of her awards there. She might have just started out, I worked with her in 2005, she was just starting out, but she was already setting herself apart with her awards and naming and claiming her neighborhood. And she's still doing real estate today. Here's a makeover. We're gonna do a before and after makeover. Here's a real estate agent I worked with a number of years ago in Portland. This is what I call a blah, blah, blah bio. And maybe you'll see why. She's lived in Portland for 30 years. She's worked with many clients on the buying and selling of their homes. Her working philosophy is to create an educated environment to help her clients make decisions while negotiating their way through any transaction. I bet each one of you can say the same, yeah? She has practical background in home renovation that carries over to all periods of home. She's on the board of this center. Do you want to have her do your, you want to hand over your million-dollar home? I mean, are you excited? So I said, let's make you over. Hundreds of satisfied Oregon clients seeking homes with character and distinction rave about the prospect of buying and selling their homes under her guidance. Since 2003, she and her able team have a combined 100 years of practical background in home renovation, insight, and education to successfully guide buyers and sellers to winning outcomes and top ratings for client satisfaction. She discovered her passion for real estate while negotiating Monopoly as a third grader, and the combination of art, heart, market knowledge, and skills set her and her team apart. Isn't that a little bit better? It's a little bit better because we know that hundreds of people have worked with her. She's got a team, she's been doing this a long time, and she discovered her passion for it as a third grader. So it's not just what she does for groceries, it's what she does for love and money. And that says a lot. I think it's a lot better. Hope you agree. Here's Terry Foster. I tried to capture a screen capture from a beautiful ad she runs in the Bellevue Club Reflections magazine. But she's actually got these happy clients and dream results, sassy sound bites attributed to real people in real neighborhoods to provide powerful proof that she's the team to go to for closing these kinds of deals. What if today you decided that you're going to assemble five or more awesome testimonials from your most recent clients and you're going to showcase them in a similar way? Wouldn't that be a powerful proof point to help your clients say yes to you? And wouldn't that be a brilliant way to start the new year? So how do you apply all this? Who's ready to declare their intention to be major in their field starting today? Yay! So ask your clients to speak the truth about you. Ask from your heart, I would really like to attract more clients just like you. I'll tell you a story. I know I'm not a real estate agent, but I've had ups and downs in my business too. And I used to be a full service PR person. And I had this awesome client who was actually kind of related to the real estate business. They handled all the corporate housing for Microsoft. The client was Avoda. And I worked with them for a number of years, and we just accomplished great things. And it was a wonderful client relationship. And when we liked each other, we did good work. The results were ongoing and ever escalating in good terms. And one of my clients had actually decided not to do PR anymore, and it left a big hole in my schedule and a huge dip in my income. And I wanted to fill it right away. Has anyone ever had that happen? Yeah. Yeah. So I have this meeting with this person, and I said, well, we've gotten our meeting accomplished. I know what my marching orders are. I think we're complete. She says, we are. I said, may I make a request? And she said, what is it? And I said, one of my very long-term clients has completed their scope of work with me, and I find myself with a gap in my calendar where I could take on another awesome client. I love working with you. I love the work that we do. I love the results that we co-create. Might you know anyone who could benefit from the magic that I provide in service to success so that I could have even more opportunity to serve the way that I've been serving you? You know what she said? She said, I had no idea you needed more clients. I'm going to get referrals out to you tonight, and you'll probably fill your calendar tomorrow. And you know what? She did. If you ask for what you want, sometimes you get what you ask for. So be courageous. Ask for referrals. Ask for testimonials. Ask for introductions to people of influence who could help you play a bigger game. You have no idea what magic is awaiting for you if you could just find the courage to ask. Who's going to start asking? Final bio blunder. Are you ready? It's failure to share your message. Some people just consider their bio an afterthought instead of a brilliant billboard for their brilliance. Some of you admitted earlier in the conversation today that you said it and forget it, like whenever you did it, and you haven't looked back. But what I would like to consider is just like the smoke detector in your house. You know how you change the battery in your smoke detector like every season? Just to make sure the house doesn't burn down. What if you decided today that once a quarter you're going to take a look at your bio and you're going to say, is it on fire with possibility? Does it reflect the contributions that I've made the last quarter? Does it show the awards and the recognition that I've achieved in the last period of time? Does it reflect the even more awesome testimonials that I've achieved since the first time I did this? And if it hasn't been updated, take the opportunity to refresh it so that your career will be on fire instead of house, right? So why does this matter? Because I learned this from Alice Cunningham, who sells hot tubs, Olympic Hot Tub Company. Mm-hmm. She says you want to make your business easy to own, easy to buy, easy to own, and easy to refer. And if you're like our sponsor, the You know, he's getting plenty of referrals from happy people. Awesome sauce. But like I'm known as the business bio expert. And if you go to Google and you type those words in, 22,400,000 results in 0.54 seconds. It all points to me, even if you don't know how to spell my name. Type in business bio expert, you'll see pictures of me, you'll have all kinds of credible references that say, she's the gal that knows how to do that well. What if you were the gal or the guy that knew how to do that well? Do a Google search for your name. Do a Google search for Maple Valley Real Estate Specialist. See what comes up. If it's not you, then do something to change it. And here's another like transparent story. Looking at the time, how am I doing? I'm doing okay, right? When I first did this, like there's no shame, blame, or judgment. We all have humble moments. I'm gonna share a really good one. Are you ready? Yeah. Okay. When I decided I didn't want to be behind the curtain, behind clients, making them look big in the media, and then I wanted to be the expert in front, the first thing I did was a Google search for my name. And I said, what does Google say about me? And at the time, I was doing a lot of running, doing 10K races and half marathons, but I wasn't a speed demon, no siree. So when I did my first Google search, you know what came up? Nancy Jutton runs really slowly. Really slowly. And I thought, if I'm so good at building buzz for my name, maybe I better do something about that. So I have done press releases, I have written articles, I have spoken on all kinds of live and virtual stages, I have contributed commentary and columns to the Puget Sound Business Journal and to the Snohomish County Business Journal. I have put out more content than God made little green apples, and if you look for me, you will find those race times, but you gotta really work hard. Because, you know, a friend of mine was in the real estate business and she lost everything in the Great Recession, and when you Google her name, it basically said, she lost everything in the Great Recession, and yet her reinvention career was teaching people how to achieve prosperity. And she had a real disconnect between what Google was saying and what she was now doing. So she just got super serious about creating content to drive these old results down and keep the new results up. And now she's running herself a nice six-figure business as a prosperity coach, and she uses the dip in her experience as a vulnerable story that she shares so that she can bring people into the fold and they feel like they belong. So it doesn't have to, like I'm a slow runner, but I'm a long distance runner and I'm still here 16 years later. Are you gonna be here 16 years later? You know, how bad do you want it, right? This is a ninja tip. I always weave this one in. What's going on between your ears? Do you believe that you are the very best at your space? In your geography, with your customer service? If you believe that you are the very best and you show up as the very best, you can accomplish anything. You can overcome any objection. You can climb any mountain. You can make anything possible, because if you believe what it is that you're here to do and you stay true to the big why that you're doing it, nothing will stop you. Fall down 7, get up 8, keep on fighting. But if you do not believe and you don't have the right mindset to show up as a star at Hello, chances are that's gonna sort of poison everything else that you do. And I know this because I've struggled with this myself. You know, I'm not good enough. You know, someday I'll be worthy to have that. You know, have you ever had any of those thoughts go through your mind? Like, stop that. Like Bob Newhart says, don't do that anymore. Just stop.